What's a dark secret questionable practice in your profession which we regular folks would know nothing about? You know, the people who write instruction manuals or user guides in things you buy, half the time, they've never even seen or touched the product. Some dude just sends us pictures, a rough description of how it's supposed to work, and that's it. Instruction manual writer here. Although for software, you know how there are always frequently asked questions? I have no idea what's frequently asked. I make all of them up. Young kids talk to their teachers, coaches, counselors, principals about their parents a lot, and kids pick up on all the dirty little secrets. Many hotels often sell rooms multiple times. Used to work in airport hotel, knowing that chances are some guests won't arrive due to missed or delayed flights, so we sell more rooms that we have. You have guests checking out from 2/3 AM due to early flights, so even though the room is technically still theirs, you quickly and sometimes poorly clean the room and tell the arriving unexpected guest or new booking there's a random computer issue and to wait 20 minutes and then check them into the departed guest's room praying. Multiple times I've had to run a kettle under a cold tap to hide the fact the previous guest used it 15 minutes before the new guest arrives. Not currently my profession, but ghost writers in fiction. John Grisham, Danielle Steele, James Patterson, Janet Ivanovich, etc. All those big names with a net bestseller every year use ghostwriters who are never credited or mentioned. It's barely even a secret. Many bills are literally written by lobbyists or special interest organizations. I have seen my boss give bill language to a state legislator and then found the same language in print a few days later several times. The bill may change in committee, but usually not drastically against the original intent. Sometimes we learn something the day before we teach it to you. I've had a couple teachers say they were also learning parts of a course as they were teaching it to us. Actually made me feel a little better about asking questions about the subject. Sometimes librarians read the new books before registering them in the catalog for the public. Evil laughter. That's the most adorable evil thing. Air traffic control, cue the Breaking Bad jokes, a diagnosis of virtually any mental illness, DART, and a diagnosis of many physical conditions, is disqualifying and will end your career. For that reason, people avoid doctors like the plague. Customs broker here. Every day hundreds of thousands of containers and air shipments arrive into United States territory. The volume of customs entries entered every day is staggering. When we get licensed to be a customs broker, we are trained and tested not just on knowledge, but ethics. We even take a pledge to partner with CBP to uphold the law, and cooperate with them should we come across anything suspicious. Why so much emphasis on this? Customs can't actually screen everything coming in. I'm oversimplifying, but CBP basically works on the honor system. You file an entry saying what the shipment is, and they just take your word for it and release it. This happens hundreds of thousands of times a day. Maybe at best customs can screen 3-7% of what's coming in. The rest is just waved through. How many people who work with children, teachers, child care workers, etc., don't follow confidentiality guidelines? Gossiping about families with co-workers, talking about children's home situations, creeping families' social media, etc. Have you ever started filling out a form for a quote on something, insurance website, or literally anything, and then changed your mind and said, "Nah, I don't want to give them my personal information," and then abandoned the form before pressing submit? If you think that stopped them from getting your personal information, it didn't. Most companies looking to capture leads will capture your info in real time as you enter it into a form. The submit button is just there to move you to the next step, not to actually send your information to the company. I work in logistics, trucking, rail, ocean, air freight. Everyone lies about everything, all the time. Logistics is similar to waiting on your drug dealer. I'll be there in 5 minutes. There is at least one water bottle, soda can, energy drink, spray paint can sitting on a piece of blocking behind your drywall somewhere in your house. You can buy stamps from your mailbox. Just leave a note and money and stamps will be there the next day. Also, if you don't have a stamp, you can leave a letter in the mail with some change taped to it and that will pay for the stamp. At a very large pizza chain restaurant that remains widely popular, we had these perforated pans for thin crust and stuffed crust pizzas. They'd get washed in the dishwasher by the hundreds per day and at least half would still have burnt cheese inch on them. Well, they were just stacked to dry when making new pizzas in those pans. Sometimes the pans that were left to dry overnight grew bits of mold around the burnt cheese. We were told just to put the dough on top because otherwise we'd never keep up with the orders if we rewashed everything. The manager said, "Don't worry, it gets cooked." Outages occur, sure. Bugs happen too. Most of the time these things are known and are put off until they happen or are complained about. Padding paperwork. Studies. To slow an auditor down. Every data point. All the minutiae of the calculations. Unnecessarily dense explanations of statistical methods that go on at length with notes about distribution fitting. They, auditors, aren't usually very technical. So they stop at each spot along the way without realizing they can throw half the thing out. If you're good, you can balloon a 30-page document into 100 in a matter of minutes. A lot of the time the engineer you talked about your project, and decide to trust with it, delegates it to cheaper contractors as soon as you sign the paperwork. Their job is new business. I work on a popular teen TV show. All the lead actors do coke regularly and they often come to set high or show up to set late because they chose to party on a Monday night. People always complain that Disney, in example, always hires old people for their roles. I mean, would you hire a teenager for a show that might either have a pilot and one season or maybe run 4 years if it's successful? I mean, would you really? You don't remember when you were a teenager all the stupid you did? Now add fame and income. When we take x-rays of your pelvis, we can see your penis, and we can see your labial folds. I was more embarrassed seeing the massive turd I was storing on the x-ray when the cute tech handed over my charts. Scuba instructor. We preach how important safety is to our students. When we dive for fun and without paying customers until we get up to some very questionable sh. University professor. We don't actually read your entire answer. Most of us don't. I remember when I was a little kid I had this teacher who was a hard ass for no reason. At that age I hadn't yet become a brain-dead idiot and was actually pretty smart academically, so I finished a test before everyone else. When I got up to turn it in, she skimmed over it and told me it needed more work and to sit back down. I just erased and then rewrote exactly what I had written before so I looked like I made changes and then turned it in several minutes later. I still remember her exact words. Now this is much better. I did the work too fast, so obviously I was just being lazy, right? Services costs are based on how much money you look like you have. I'm a woodworker contractor. I come to you housed. You tell me what you want done. My jumping off point is how much the market will bear. If I think you can afford a $4,000 solid oak bookcase, that's what I will quote you. I can make a cheaper version that I make less money on. But why would I do that? It's not that I'm just ripping you off. I'm selling you a better product. But in doing so I make more money. So when getting a quote, it can pay to be very direct about what you want to spend, or you are going to be sold the most expensive version they think you can afford. If it has to be accessed regularly in an IT setting, it's not secure. Not unless you're in an industry that actually polices it. Yes, people are dumb enough to pick up USB thumb drives they find on the ground. The nicer and newer it is, the more likely it'll get plugged in. Also, if you're looking to verify the security of your vendors, don't announce your visit. You do not want to know how long food sits on the loading dock before it gets into the cooler. There is a problem in substance abuse treatment in the United States called body brokering. Substance abuse treatment can be very expensive and insurance companies pay a lot of money for a patient to be there. Treatment centers will hire body brokers to find addicts with the best, highest paying insurance and entice them to check into the specific center. The treatment center then gives the broker a commission from the insurance money. This can go as far as body brokers literally putting more drugs into the hands of some addicts before they come in. BC The higher level of drugs in your system upon admit, the more and longer the insurance company will pay to the treatment center. Brokers will also hire other addicts in a pyramid scheme type way to check into the treatment center, make friends with the other patients, and upon discharge encourage relapse so they come back to treatment. I work at a theme park and we use codes with number 4 situation that could happen in the park to not create panic. We also use codes for some category of people. Like a code 25 means there's a fire. Code 20 is for mentally disabled people. We also use hand signals sometimes for some situations. former retail pharmacy technician. I received many forged prescriptions for strong narcotics for otherwise seemingly young, healthy patients. In hindsight, it's really sad, because I'm witnessing the opioid crisis unfold before my eyes. But the pharmacist has full discretion to pretend we don't have the drug in stock, turn people away, or straight up call the cops. We will literally put on our acting game and keep these people at the pharmacy until the cops arrive. The real reason programmers have so many screens is because one of them almost always has Google pulled up on it. No one knows what they are doing 100% of the time. It's typically always hum this should work or well hope this works. Documentary editor here. This varies depending on the content genre, but documentaries can never be completely true. The ethics of filmmaking is disputed among many theorists. Those who work on documentaries understand that they are almost as fictional as completely made up stories. Again, this depends on the project, but some common practices like frankenbiting, splicing sentences and words to create a different message, used especially in reality TV and really dramatic docs, are necessary to making a documentary watchable. There are hundreds of hours of footage, and if you see or hear something in a documentary, the creators wanted you to be exposed to that over a different piece of footage. This can lead to lives being destroyed, whether a person is posed as the enemy or antagonist, or they are displayed in a way that does not represent them accurately, which is most, if not all, of the time. I've had to take mental health days off from working because I become so worried about how these people's lives will be affected by my decisions. Lot of unethical shipping companies even today dump a lot of garbage, oily sludge, waste contaminated water and oil out when sailing in international waters far away from the shore. There are only a few handful players today who are actually executing business trades while still keeping the carbon footprint and environment as one of their core policies. I am glad to be working with one of them. I am a merchant marine who works as an engineer on mega container ships like this. Disclaimer. Link takes you to my YouTube video of a container ship in port and eventually sailing off under the Golden Gate Bridge. Some stores that sell used merchandise like video games and movies will pay you money for stolen stuff even when they know it's stolen. It doesn't hurt them to get brand new games that were only released hours ago for a fraction of the cost. Then they turn around and sell them for $5 cheaper than a new copy. They are getting brand new never opened $60 games for a few bucks, and making a huge profit. Church worker here. This may be specific to the church I work for, but I think it's pretty common for bigger, 1000 plus members, churches. They are two-faced. They'll tell the janitorial crew janitorial service is truly a ministry, and it's so good and so important. But guess what? When the church needs to make cutbacks, we're some of the first ones screwed over. We're the ones expected to clean until 2 to 3 a.m. on a Sunday morning after people have used the building until midnight. As a woman, I've straight up been harassed by the guy pretty high up in the church hierarchy, and nobody really has my back. There are so many fake, judgmental, hateful people who hide behind the guise of Christianity. People who will lock people out of the building and laugh at them. They tell the people who aren't dressed presentable enough to sit in the back. If that person isn't run off by their frozen, hateful stares. This is so anti what a church and Christianity should be. Funeral director. You can buy a casket from Costco for 20% of the price that I'm going to sell you one for. About 70% of the cost of the funeral is overcharging options and leading you on to feel guilty if you don't take them. We have a lot of fun when we don't deal with customers, but we never have that fun with bodies. I used to work fast food, not gone a day where every single person I work with had tried marijuana, but that's lame. So let's take it up another step. In reality, the majority of people come here for work because we have nowhere else, either. We grew up in poverty and never had a chance to go to college. We commit crimes in our youth that we regret or struggle with drugs and alcohol. In my Northwest state, a raise from minimum wage to $10, like we got because of the virus. We're essential workers and are rewarded for working in a crisis. But when you go to a fast food restaurant, just think about why we're there. Yeah, we made mistakes. Yes, we're facing consequences. But they aren't bad people. My coworker who was an ex-cartel member with face tattoos was nicer than most of the elderly white customers I met. He's twice the man as many people I've met. The people here are coming for a second chance. PLZ, let us have it. Pretty much any software you use is jacked together spaghetti with no tests. The markup on glasses, specifically frames, is stupid ridiculous. We can buy a frame for $4, then turn around sell it for $160. Lenses too. Lenses that cost us under $10 can easily be marked up to $100. I mean, business is business, but taking advantage of people who can't see is sorta shtye, lol.